She just wants to be beautiful. She goes unnoticed. She knows no limits. She craves attention. She praises an image. She prays to be sculpted by the sculptor. Oh, she don't see the shining.
What up, my beautiful supporters? Welcome back. As you can see, I've already got my eyebrows done, but I'm so happy to see that you stopped by. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe, tag a friend below, or interact with me. I want to get to know you guys. First, you're going to moisturize your face. I already did that off camera, but I'm going to go in with my Maybelline Master Prime and apply this to my face. As you can see, I'm using my fingertips to apply the makeup primer. This really allows you to work the product into your skin. Next, I'm going to go in with Urban Decay Setting Spray. This helps control the oil, deflect the surface shine, and help makeup stay put. If you know you have a long night ahead of you of sweating or whatever you're about to be doing, spray it before and after and you'll be all set. Next, I'm gonna go in with my green corrector stick from Smashbox. I'm gonna apply it to all the areas I wanna cover up, all the redness, and any places that I'm just like, ooh. This is just a reminder, you don't have to do this step. You can just skip it and go right ahead to foundation. I just like to go the extra mile and correct the places that I want to correct. As you can see, next I'm going to go in with my damp beauty blender and I'm going to blend this green right out so I don't look like I have polka dots all over my face. There are also other colors that you can use, such as the salmon pinkish color, which is perfect for brightening under the eye area, or purple, which mutes kind of a yellow undertones, or oranges that can correct more severe dark circles. It all depends on your face and what you're trying to correct. Next, I'm going to go in with Tarte Shape Tape in Fair Neutral, and I'm going to apply this to all the areas that I corrected. And as per usual, I'm gonna blend this right out. Next, we're gonna go in with our foundation. I'm using Born This Way in the tone Snow. Oh yeah! Let's not forget, a little product goes a long way. I'm gonna be applying this with my damp beauty blender all over my face. Now that we're done with our face, we're gonna go in with Tarte Shape Tape once again and apply this as concealer under our eyes, our nose, underneath the chin, and any other places you would like to highlight. Let's not forget an important tip. Do not apply this under your eye bags, outlining them. Try to apply them in an upside down V to get the best results. Maybe we made a blind soul. She tries to cover up her pain. And cut her woes away. Cause cover girls don't cry after the face is made. There's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark. And of course, we're gonna go in with our beauty blender and blend this all out. And you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars, see how beautiful. With stars, oh, we're beautiful. Oh, next we're gonna go in with our contour. Our contour. I wanna go in with my contour brush, and here's a tip to use contour. You can use it to redefine your features and reshape your face in any way, shape, or form to bring out your beauty, even though you guys are already beautiful. First, I'm gonna go in with my contour brush and apply this to the most hollow parts of my cheekbones. Cause who doesn't want those sharp cheekbones to cut a bitch? She has dreams to be an envy, so she's starving, you know, cover girls eat nothing, she says. After applying this to my cheekbones, I'm gonna take this underneath my lips to create some shadow and create the illusion of bigger lips. After, I'm gonna apply this underneath my jawline, cause who doesn't want a sharp jawline? I know. Next, I'm gonna put this on my nose to contour my nose. I don't wanna put too much, but I'm gonna do just a little bit. You can stop here if you want more of a subtle contour look, but I personally like having a lot of bronze. I like the warmth of my face. So I'm gonna go in with a powdered contour and apply this in all the areas that I wanna bronze and contour. Once you finish doing that, I like to go in with my translucent powder and bake this shit. Yes, the key is to make it look like you got flour all over your face, boo. But it's okay, your makeup gonna look flawless though. She just wants to be beautiful, she goes unnoticed, she knows. Go girl, you can bake it. Next, we're gonna go in with our eyelids. I like to take Anastasia 0.5 concealer and apply this to my eyelids and blend it out with my fingers. I like to use this as a base before I apply my eyeshadow. I also like to go in with some translucent powder and apply it above the concealer on my eyes just to avoid getting creases in my eyeshadow. And ba-bam! What to do? I'm gonna be taking some random tape, and it's gonna help me define my look and make it look more sharp. Just keep in mind where you place the tape is how high or low your eyeshadow is gonna be. So I'm gonna go in with this Tarte eyeshadow palette in the color Caregiver. I'm gonna be applying this to the crease and use this as a transition color. After, I'm gonna go in with my Total Pro palette and I'm gonna be using the dark brown. And I'm gonna be applying this to the inner crease of my eye. After, I'm gonna go in with the clean brush and I'm gonna be smoothing out the edges and blending them right out. After applying those two colors, I'm gonna take Anastasia 0.5 concealer using a flat brush and I'm gonna be cleaning up my eyelid and making it look more like a cut crease eyeshadow look. Next, I'm gonna go in with the yellow from the Total Pro palette and I'm gonna be applying this to the areas that I put concealer and cleaned up. After applying the yellow, I'm gonna go back in with my brown and blend that out between the yellow and the brown so it doesn't look so harsh, and blend that right in. There you go. I'm gonna go back in with my blending brush and I'm gonna blend out the harsh edges at the very top and I'm gonna make sure it looks smooth. Next, I'm going to go in with my super skinny eyeliner, and I'm going to be applying this. One good tip about the tape is that it helps you have a sharp eyeliner to cut motherfuckers. And keep it clean, sharp line. And once you're done with the eyeliner, this is what it's going to be looking like. You can either stop right here and just keep it at that, but I was feeling hella extra, so I decided to put some glitter on my cut crease. I'm going in with Candy Cosmetics. I'm going with their sugar water, and I'm going to be applying a gold on my lid where the cut crease is, just to have a little pop, 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 pop. You know how it be. So doing all that extra glitter and whatnot, I'm going to go back in with my E22 brush from Morphe, and I'm going to be mimicking what I did to the top to the bottom with my dark brown. And once you finish doing that, stick your tongue out like, eh. Just kidding. I'm going to go right ahead and boom, do my other eye. This is what the look's going to look like. Woo-hoo. So I'm going to take a brush. I'm going to brush all this translucent powder off. And let's do this thing. Girl, you almost done. Sculpted by the sculptor. Oh, she don't see the light that's shining. I'm gonna go into lipsticks. What to choose? What to choose? Shake it like a Macarena, shake it like a Macarena. But I'm gonna go with Child Star from Melted. And I'm gonna be applying this to my lips. What the final look is gonna look like. If you hung in there, thank you so much for your support. Don't forget to subscribe. If you recreate this look, don't forget to tag me. I'll put down my social medias below. Thank you for everything, guys. Stay tuned for the next video. Hope you liked it. Mwah.